Show. We are a once a week broadcast from Manchester, New Hampshire, where we are pro pot, pro gun, and pro coffee. You can find all of our content at rebelloveshow.com. I am Rob Mathias.
And I'm your Rebel Mistress. Oh, so hi, Rob. How's your weekend been?
My weekend was fantastic. I actually had to, I did a lot. Worked a weekend. It kind of sucks, but this upcoming weekend I'm excited about. But
you know, I don't work weekends, I feel like I just sleep.
Well, you're lucky. You work a Monday through Friday job. I know you hate your job.
You think I'm lucky? I think you're lucky.
How am I lucky?
I love retail schedule.
No. I hate my work schedule. Like, it's every once in a while I have to work late nights or early mornings. I have to work weekends. Almost always have to work weekends.
Well, babe,
so I miss out on a lot. Just
we should just give it all up and weekend. Be rock stars for liberty.
But I'm down for being a rock star for liberty. I can do that all night long.
We went out with a few of our porcupines on Friday. Was that Friday? Was that Friday or Saturday? We went to Chuck.
Yeah.
I forgot about that.
That was so long ago. That was
literally
Saturday.
Like yesterday. It was Saturday. We went out with a few porcupines.
Well, it was a Shire sharing fundraising event where it was a group outing.
So go if you don't know what Shire sharing is, go type it in Facebook. They organize. What is
Shire sharing is basically it's a voluntary. Organization for a charity. So basically, long story short, it's a nonprofit, but hugely nonprofit. Like that.
That's not telling at all what Shire Sharing is.
I haven't even got to. I have to explain like the backstory of what Shire Sharing is. So like Shire Sharing is not like a normal charity where you know like they have a tax exempt 501c3 blah 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 blah. It's just now she's a state rep, Amanda Bolden, organizing a. A charity where she, her father used to do it back in Texas before she moved here, where they would feed, they would organize a collection of food before Thanksgiving and hand deliver Thanksgiving dinners to people in need. She would get actually the lists of the people that she needs to, that people that need food. Basically through like different charities and different churches and stuff like that, just like a list of families that are in need. And even during the assembly of the food, they actually do it toward dietary needs depending on the family.
Yeah.
But it's in a fundraising phase.
We did it last year. We went out because they actually go out. They take a giant bus. It's great. Facebook did a story about it actually last year.
Yeah, they had a documentary crew there.
Yeah, they had a documentary crew there talking about Facebook stories. So I'm sure you can find that somewhere. But anyway, we got on this big bus as a big group, which was really fun. We went to a warehouse and then we packed the bags. You know, some bags had turkeys, some bags had veggies and turkeys, whatever. We loaded them onto the bus and then we just set out. Like, it was our mission.
And what's crazy is like a lot of like the local grocery stores donate food, and the warehouse that was being organized at was that space was donated for that day.
Wasn't it by Stone Farm or something?
No, the warehouse was by the assembly was at the airport.
Oh,
it was
okay.
Warehouse right off the airport.
Oh, okay. I didn't know it was the warehouse, the airport's warehouse.
Well, it's not the airport's warehouse. It's just right off. By the way. It's literally, you can see the airport from it.
Oh, okay. But yeah, so that was a lot of fun. So this year they're doing the same things and you can donate. I know they have their QR code on their website, which is just
ShireSharing.org. Yeah.
Go donate.
But awesome. Saturday, though, yeah, that was the. That was like their first fundraising event. It wasn't really one, it was just a reason to go see Rocky Horror.
Well, you can donate. Amanda's great. It was my first time seeing Rocky Horror Picture Show, so I don't know if you've ever seen it, but it was so fun. She brought everyone like these prop bags full of like glitter and toast, like literally cooked toast, like spray bottles for rain, and it was very interactive. And we trashed that theater. It was great. It was a fun time.
Well, I've gone to Rocky Horrors in the past, in the last like 10 years. I've gone to different ones. Not every year. I've only gone to like a handful. And the ones I've gone to in the past before I moved here were never at like a. I've never, first off, Chunky's. Have you ever been to Chunky's? It's It's a restaurant that has a movie theater in it. Like, they serve food and alcohol and stuff like that, and have tables and, like, really comfortable chairs. It's not what you're used to in a normal movie theater. But when I was seeing an old movie theater, everyone got up to dance, and during literally every single dance scene, every dance scene, there's people up dancing.
Well,
and that only happened in the first scene,
But you have to admit, we tore it up hard in that first scene. Like, I was I got up and I was like dancing, and I had to sit down for the rest of the time. But that was, I guess that was like one of the highs of my weekend. I really loved seeing Rocky Horror, and it just gets me excited for activism in the fall, because now I know we're going to get to, like, this is just leading up to all these fun things, not just the fundraisers, but I actually really love going and helping deliver the bags for Shiner Sharing, because people are just so appreciative and grateful, and I just really like giving back, and I think that's awesome.
Oh, you definitely get a high off of, doing something good and doing some charity thing. Like, you actually do feel a lot better about it, and you're helping someone else too, so it's kind of like a win-win.
Yeah.
You know, I'm looking forward to it. I'm definitely looking forward to the comedy show that's going to be, November 4th? It's right after when we come back from Keenevention. It's at Murphy's.
Yeah. And we're actually donating something, because they're doing a raffle there.
I also plan to buy a bunch of raffle tickets too.
Nice. Yeah. So, I mean, if you want to check out Shiner Sharing and donate, go find them. They got a QR code, because of course they take Bitcoin.
Yeah. Well, that's such a cool charity that they take Bitcoin.
Exactly. You know, it makes you want to support.
Send them like a half a Bitcoin. You'll feed like 10 families in Manchester area. You know, so if you're sitting on that kind of, that little bit of Bitcoin or a lot, depending on who you are,
Yeah, hand some over. But I think that was pretty much all I did this weekend. I don't feel like I did anything else, at least that I can remember.
That's what you can talk about.
That I can talk about or remember. Two of the same.
What did you think of my costume? My cosplay at Rocky Horror.
So Rob went in just his tidy white.
No, I went as Brad.
He went as Brad.
Second year in a row
scene.
Went as Brad.
Oh, you went as Brad last year, too?
Yeah, but I went as Brad, like, in the very beginning, where he's, like, dressed up, like, in a tux and stuff.
Oh,
like
and this time he went as Brad naked.
So I had tidy whiteys on, so that was something.
Yeah.
I'll admit, like, walking into a movie theater wearing nothing but, like, tidy whiteys and, like, walking in.
How did it feel, Rob?
It felt empowering, to be perfectly honest.
You're
no one batted an eye. Like, oh, yeah, here's your ticket. You know, I'm standing here in just my underwear, but it's okay because it's Rocky Horror. But if I did it the night before, I would have been, like, kidnapped by the local gang known as the police department and thrown into a cage.
You had on, like, that white shirt over it, so it technically counts as clothing.
I could have went with just that, and I probably would have been fine.
Probably.
They probably wouldn't have said anything.
I have to admit, babe, you were hot. I think that should go on your Tinder profile.
I should take the picture of me in just my underwear standing in front of a movie theater and put that in my Tinder profile.
I think you should put that on your Tinder profile, because one thing everyone looks for on Tinder is, you know, creativeness. And babe, I gotta admit, that's pretty creative.
You think that's creative?
Yeah. 100%. How are you doing in the Tinder realm?
I don't know. Lately Tinder's been... it's been a downer lately. I don't know. Like, there's so much spam on Tinder now, to the point where, like, this week I actually put this aside.
When you say spam, what do you mean?
If you swipe right on someone, but most of those profiles that I see, half of them now are, like, fake profiles.
Like, what? Can I see, a fake profile? I think I know what you're talking about, because once I went on a guy friend of mine's dating profile, and he was talking to some girl, and he was like, I can't tell if she's, like, real or not.
If you can't tell, then it's not real, folks. Like,
I mean,
I think that's
the consensus. If you can't tell, then it's not real. But it's very convincing, because if you don't answer, she'll say, hey, why are you not responding? So I don't know. Maybe it could possibly be real. More on dating when we come back, and then we'll get into what we're looking forward to. It's Keenevention, baby. Peace.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled free aid. offers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on doing the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why AMP is I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your AMP will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com. And getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
Instead of listening, you can also watch. See the Liberty Radio Network's key New Hampshire-based live shows via our studio cam at cam.lrn.fm. Plus, you'll still be able to listen to the Liberty Radio Network via the cam feed in high quality 24/7, even when there's no live show being produced in our Keene studio. But wait, there's more. Our chat room is built into the cam page so you can interact with other listeners online. Listen, watch, and chat. All free at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right.
Should we set up like a Amazon link? With Bitcoin. I know this
sounds unbelievable, but it might. Why are you on LRN.fm and not RebelLoveShow.com? This information is worth you changing the way you do things. What are you doing, babe? Please use our site.
Get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25%.
Who's LP?
I don't know. Just call me out by my last name.
Mr. Mathias. LP.
Liberty Phoenix.
Oh, hi.
Is that Liberty Phoenix? Hey, Liberty Phoenix, is that you? Is that LP? Is that you?
Hi, Ken. I miss you. Shop.lrn.fm.
Give $5 a month to the AMP program. Hey, so what are we coming back with?
The next thing on the... All kinds of things. We weren't done talking about it. How about you not have short-term memory loss?
How
about
you
literally stop the show in the middle of our conversation.
No judges here, babe. No judgments.
Yes, every time you ask me what we're talking about when coming up, I'm going to judge you.
I want to do that every time.
That's such a loaded question. Whatever we end up talking about. Want me to bring us back?
Yes, I'll come. I'll bring, because I brought it up in the beginning. We'll take turns.
Okay.
Okay, so I'll take the next one.
So you'll take the next one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so when do you want me to bring it back after that?
No, you're bringing it back this time.
Oh, okay, you'll take the one time.
Yeah.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to,
it's not free for us.
You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Before we left, Rob was telling us about all his spam bots on Tinder lately. What if you thought I was a spam bot? What if you were like, nah, she's just a spam bot? Do you have an example of the kind of messages you're getting from these spam bots?
Usually it's just messages of like, you know, hey, you look cute or you look sexy.
Want to chat? Click this link.
Text me at this number, blah, 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 blah. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Then that's definitely... Well, how do you know it's spam?
Well...
What is it, an 800 number?
You can
kind of
tell it's spam. Like, here's this person right here that I matched with. And it's like it's always three to four pictures.
She's cute.
But the thing is, they don't have any description, no similar likes, nothing. No connections whatsoever.
Maybe she's just a basic bitch.
No. It's every time I match with something like that, like it's usually a fake account. I leave it on there for a little bit, then I usually delete it. They got to have something in there. If you're that stupid to make a profile and not have one thing in the profile, like just message me.
At least, hey.
Yeah.
Hey is just hey, you know? I mean, I guess as far as my dating life, even though you didn't ask.
Well, I'm sorry, babe. How has your dating life been? What's going on in your world?
I mean, pretty much nothing. There's pretty much, everyone's just so uninteresting. And I'm done with uninteresting chicks. I
will say this, that maybe we...
Well, I had a girl that I liked, or I like. Okay. And then it's like, it's the effort, it's the amount of effort you have to put in to talk to a chick. Like, it's so much easier if we were all, like, gay men and we could just be like, hey, and then it just happens. Like, hey, okay, let's go do this. I don't know. Women are so fucking complicated. I don't know, man.
It's a lot of work with you guys.
It is a lot of work, and I just don't have, like, the energy for it. So, I mean, that's pretty much how
you pretty much wish that all other women that were bi or lesbian were acting like gay men?
Pretty much. I wish that it'd just be a bit easier and, like, that would just be easy. Because I would talk to more women if it wasn't all of that back and forth. Like, I don't have time for that. Like, with a guy, it's just easy. A guy and a girl is the same way as two gay men. I can say hi.
Men are very upfront about what we want.
Yeah. On OkCupid, men are just like, you talk to them forever. And I think it's the talking to people forever thing that I don't really like.
No, I never do that. I jump to the point.
And then you're always like,
if I strike out or whatnot, oh well, there's someone. I'm not gonna waste a month of chatting with someone at OKC just to get a date. Like, no, hey, you're cool. We're talking for like a couple of days. Do you want to get a cup of coffee? Do you want to go out to dinner? All right, have a nice day. Move along.
I mean, but I feel like you're too quick to jump the gun. I don't even like load the gun. I'm just like, whatever.
Well, it depends on what I'm looking for. I mean, obviously, if it's like a date, if I'm like seeing someone that I want to like should go out with, that's one thing. And like if it's like straight up sex, that's a whole another thing.
I mean, there's this meme that I seen on Facebook. I totally forgot that like how it goes.
That sounds like a hilarious meme.
I know, but it is really funny. It's just like gay girls flirting, and it's like, oh, you're so cute. But if you say that to a girl, like
women say that to each other anyways.
Yeah. She'll be like, oh, thank you. And then you're like, no, like I'm trying to be gay with you.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Like how do gay women like how do they present themselves in a way that doesn't come across as straight acting women that are just giving flattery to their girlfriends? Like how do you come across as I'm interested in you?
I don't know. I literally have no idea. Like, it's so hard with women, I'm telling you. So, I mean, all the other women that I've talked to or been interested in, it's just kind of been made abundantly clear. Like, because most of it was couples, just like what you're into. But just like girl on girl, like, I have no idea. Like, I'll talk to girls and like I'll even get to the point where we go out for a coffee. But it's really weird because... You just don't know. It's that line between I'm being nice to you or I'm being gay with you. Like, let's fuck. So I don't know. Like, I've been trying to get that same girl to, like, bang.
She's probably listening right now.
Like, I've been trying to, like, get her to bang. And she's just like, oh, you're so nice. You're so cute. I'm like, oh, my God. I want to have sex with you.
Just have sex with her or us or just her.
Yeah.
Either one. Just do it.
I shouldn't have to, you know, spell it out because that just makes it awkward. Like, I don't have to spell it out for men. Like, if I say I want to go on a date with you and I say, oh, you look nice, and I rub your arm, you're not like, oh, thanks, girlfriend. You're like, yeah, she wants to bone me. Like, if I'm on a date with a girl, it should mean the same thing, right?
It should. It should. Absolutely.
It doesn't, though. Like, I don't know what's going on.
Well, that sucks, babe. I don't know. Maybe you should have me talk to her.
I don't know. But anyway, I think this weekend is actually going to be a highlight weekend.
This is going to be like, it's, what is it, season finale of of season six, so to speak. This is season six or season seven. I pretty much lost track. But at any rate, Keenevention is coming up in literally a couple of days. It's literally in a couple of days. It's this Friday.
So is the season finale?
Yeah, of course. Season finale. Yeah, I would say season finale. I would have said season premiere, but that's not the case. This is really a season finale event.
Okay, so when does the season premiere start directly after that, or is that another event?
It doesn't have to be another event. It actually can coincide. The same event can like continue over.
I felt like last Keenevention was a season finale as well.
Oh, I would agree.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. There's a lot of plot twists that happen right there during Keenevention.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, there's a Keenevention miracle. I mean, we got back together on the dance floor at the Halloween dance party.
Oh, yes, we did. And when is that?
That is this Saturday.
Can people still buy tickets for Keenevention?
They are still on sale, and they take Bitcoin, which is very cool of Keenevention organizers. I believe you can actually get just a pass to the dance bar. I'm not 100% sure. I should probably look into that.
Yeah, no, you can. I've seen it. There's a suggested donation of $10, I think. But it's worth it. You should definitely come party with us. Speaking of partying like crazy, I think since this year's Keenevention is our season finale, and it's a freaking dance party with a laser beam.
I'll build a miracle. If you went to Pork Fest, all right, at Pork Fest for the big gay dance party, there's this whole huge laser light show. It's like it's a huge, huge white tent, like a huge canopy tent, and inside in the middle of the night was just this laser light show all over the place. If you're rolling hard, you can like feel the music bounce off the lasers. Like it's intense. It's gonna be at Keenevention for the Halloween dance party,
Derek J is hosting that, and he knows how to party, so it's gonna be a good time, and we're gonna be rolling.
Oh yes.
Rolling.
Yeah, we save that for special occasions for the most part.
I do. I think the golden rule, which I mean, I'm gonna read you guys some fun facts. You should wait 30 days in between your illicit drug use.
Wait. We're gonna have to bring that back after a break. 30 days for every illicit drug, or just
no. Together, we'll talk more when we come back.
All right.
Money, power, and respect are all yours at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Be seen as an industry leader. You can do it. The last application you filled out when it was time to hit submit.
Let's go back to the chat. Who's in
you didn't get the approval.
Where
you
is the chat at?
There's a better way. We teach you exactly.
All right, back to
the
chat.
The right systems, the right way, the first time.
I had to hock my mixer.
$1,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools in your new corporate credit engine so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at CreditSuccessSecretsRevealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-707-8719. That's 1-800-707-8719.
I love Kickstarter's comment. Anyone giving that kind of advice 30 days obviously doesn't know Cody. Yeah, Cody's not known for his ability to go a couple days without drugs.
This show's for you. This is all the effects of all those drugs. Riding your brain.
Yeah, this is a shout out to Cody, who's probably tripping balls on something right now.
Go, Cody.
I know. He better fucking make it to Keenevention. I still want to call him out on the show.
Yeah, we can. Credit inquiries in
your various types of credit accounts. I remember I'm bringing it back. Or maintain a healthy credit score. So, we got to talk about. See, we always forget about, because there's so many people that still listen to LRN that don't know we're live or they're listening to the podcast. And I always want to mention at least once during the episode.
Yeah, we can talk about the panels. We're still
talking about that. I'm just literally saying go to rebelowlshow.com
and click on
live. Just keep the corresponding payments within your means. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by visiting Van Dyke. It's a shame the briefing ain't here anymore.
MLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender. Charlie Sundstrom, NMLS 134251. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
Did you know you could get news updates about what's happening with the Liberty Radio Network delivered in the way you prefer?
I'm still waiting to hear the Rebel Love Show commercial. I've been listening to LRN just to hear it. You can stay in the loop by joining. We have a new commercial, guys. It's going to play at some point. LRN.FM
or follow us at Twitter at twitter.lrn.fm. It's all free. So sign up now at updates.lrn.fm for news updates delivered to your email box. Facebook.lrn.fm to follow our Facebook page. And twitter.lrn.fm to receive our tweets.
Keenevention is coming up fast.
I'm going to hire that guy to do a commercial for us. Because we can put another commercial up there.
How about the first one, please?
I know, I haven't heard it yet. It's in rotation, according to Ian. Did you know he didn't know that that was Michael W. Dean? When he was at the doers meeting, I was like, yeah, that was Michael D. He laughed. Like, that makes so much more sense. How are the seditious sirens going to be at Keenevention when the seditious sirens are no more, babe? I don't understand. Ian needs to fix this commercial.
Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Access to the Hello Keen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at Keenevention.info. Visit Keenevention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's Keenevention.info.
Just trying not to be pissed off right now.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. If you are listening to us on LRN.FM or on hopefully a few pirate radio stations across the continent known as North America, you can go to rebelloveshow.com, click on live, and you can watch our studio cam where you can see myself and my beautiful Rebel Mistress here live on in the studio of the Rebel Love Studios. And we also do... check the chat. The LRN chat is actually embedded right on there, so you can even chat with us on rebelloveshow.com. So before we left off, my Rebel Mistress here, she was talking about how she was reading an article where, you know, the proper illicit drug use, giving yourself 30 days between.
Okay, that so
seems
let me
a
clarify.
A little excessive, in
let
my
me
opinion.
Let me clarify. First of all, if you're going to be taking, like, MDMA, because I don't even remember what some long fucking word this stands for, you should do it within 30 days in between each other. So take MDMA on the 30th, and then you take MDMA on the next month. Not maybe you shouldn't do it every month, but you should definitely space out your drug use, because with MDMA, it's releasing all of your body's, what is the word, serotonin? Yeah, I think that is the word. And it drains you. So me and you have both done it before. Mm-hmm. And every time after, you feel incredibly, incredibly drained. Someone made a great comment in LRN chat. Tell that to Cody, which is a great example, because we were drained the next day. Cody was out. Like,
well, he also did way too much compared to us.
Of course, he did. And that's one of the things I was looking up was, you know, is there too much, like, can you overdose? And, you know, they were kind of just describing what it's like to overdose on it, which is just kind of the opposite of how you feel when you've done just the right amount, like super energetic, but like on like a psychedelic trip. If you take too much, you're just like Cody, eyes, pupils about to pop out of your head. Like, everything feels heavy, and you're just, like, fucking zoned, but you can't move, really. So it's, like, a bad feeling. It's like
sounds like my whenever I do a dab. Like, it just knocks me onto my ass for, like, an hour.
Really?
Yeah.
You were comparing an MDA overdose?
Well, compared to that description, like where everything's heavy and you're kind of knocked out for a while, like that doesn't happen to me on MDMA. I'm like super energetic.
Because you take the right amount.
Yeah.
You're not like.
Bulk. There's been a couple of times. I remember at the Big Gay Dance Party, I did take probably a little too much. Especially
why?
For my first time.
Oh, yeah, you got sick, right?
Yeah, I felt like I had to throw up near the end. It was literally after they shut it down at midnight. It was literally like 15 minutes afterwards. I had to literally sit down for about 20 minutes where I felt really lightheaded and like as if I needed to throw up. It passed with like just drinking some water.
I mean, yeah, that's what. Oh, another thing it says.
Drink a lot of water. If you're an MDMA newbie, have a shit ton of water nearby and, you know, keep hydrated because especially if you're going to use it in a dance situation where you're going to be dancing or if you're going to use it like in a sex something or other, like you want to have sex on MDMA or whatever, if you're going to be physically active in any way, shape, or form, drink a lot of water because you're going to be very, very physically active. You're going to be bouncing off the walls.
Especially if you're in a rave because all that heat is like making you dehydrated mm-hmm. plus all the dancing. Oh, I got the methyl dioxymethanephetamine. Oh.
Okay.
Wow. That's the full title. MDMA sounds a lot more pleasant.
Another thing going on with MDMA in the news is about how they're warning parents that you know, watch out for your kids when they're trick-or-treating because you might find some, nefarious people putting MDMA in candy and whatnot.
Sign me the fuck up.
I know, right?
Whose door do I go knock on? Trick or treat.
Like, MDMA ain't cheap, all right? Well, how
no,
would she just
not.
Be giving it out to kids who wouldn't even appreciate it? And on top of that, if you eat MDMA, like, you could taste it. It tastes horrible.
It tastes like ass. It tastes worse than ass. I don't know.
It's like licking a mineral. Like, it's like licking salt off of like a paved road in the middle of winter. Like it's a horrible taste. No kid would think that tastes like candy and want
Yay,
more.
Yeah, candy. They're like, you Mom, know? This tastes funny. I'm like, don't eat that. Give it to Mommy.
And what's crazy is like stuff like that. Like, and you know, there's other stuff out there. Oh, there's always something out there with edibles and stuff like that.
I just feel like drugs are expensive, and if someone's like trick or treating free drugs, like that's. Let me know which house to knock. Like, it's just unrealistic to think that someone's buying a bunch of drugs to give away for free.
I mean, I'm sure.
I mean, I get it's Halloween.
I'm sure it's at some point in some time that probably could have happened or might have happened. But the odds of someone doing that is so minimal because, again, you're spending money for no purpose unless your purpose is really just to fuck with some little kid, you know? But in the grand scheme of things, I don't honestly see people buying MDMA wasting it on that. Like I literally just cannot imagine somebody doing that. Now, in regards to edibles, I can see kids getting into it, like their parents' stash, and not knowing.
Oh, brownies!
You know, like, oh, there's some baked goods in the fridge. Like, I'll eat one.
I mean, I feel like as long as you you don't do that, like, you'd be smarter about it. I don't know. I'd like to think people have more common sense, but you never know. But anyway... I read a lot of stuff, and nothing I really read was, like, you know, death. Or if it is death, it's caused by something else. It's caused by, you know, not hydrating properly, taking too much in one setting. We both know someone or know of someone who is, like, perma-tripping. Like, she's just always on MDMA. Like, she's, like, fucking geeking. And, you know, at one point I'm like, is she just, like, a crackhead? So I don't know if you've ever been around someone who's just, like, tweaking all the time, but it's kind of weird because they're, like, super excited but skeptical. I don't know how to explain it.
What do you mean skeptical? Like, skeptical, is that really their behavior or what do you exactly mean by that?
It's just, like, if you're, like, they're just, like, constantly having to take it, first of all, because, like, the symptoms are, like, wearing off. So
I can relate in regards to pot. I just keep smoking it. It has less and less effect on me.
It's not the same, though, because it still affects them, but it just, like, in a different way. I don't know. It kind of looks like she has, like, cerebral palsy or something. I don't know. She's just, like, always, like...
Who are you talking about? Oh, don't even say it on
air. I'm not going to say it on air.
Do I know this person?
you met her before.
Okay. Now but I know who you're talking
yeah,
about.
Yeah, but at the time, we didn't know, like, what her deal was. I just thought she was kind of weird. And then someone told me, you know, that's why, like, that's her life goal. It's just, like, to perma trip. Which I guess if you have the time for that shit.
Hey, but, if you get the time and money.
Yeah, if you got the time you know, and
go on
money.
A psycho, if you're going to go on a psychonaut adventure, I guess go for the gold.
I don't know. I mean, I definitely like the idea of at least waiting 30 days in between, like, uses for MDMA.
Well, for me, like, for MDMA, like, I treat that in the... It's like putting the pussy on a pedestal. Like,
No, you don't. You're always like, let's take it.
Yeah, but I don't. I don't. I take it literally once a month. Once a month.
No, we took it.
No, we took it. No. We took it at Pork Fest in the end of June. Didn't even touch it in July. Then we didn't even touch it till Hemp Fest. All right. And then we did it once in September at our friend's DJ thing. And then the next time it's going to be Keenevention. It's literally been like once a month that we touch it.
I don't know. I mean, we don't have addictive personalities, so it's not even worrying about being addicted to it because it's a choice. It's still like, even this girl who's like, I guess I wouldn't even call her addicted to it. She just likes tweaking all the time, so she just fucking tweaks all the time. But I mean, eventually that shit's not, it can't be good for you because you're using all your body's like natural energy. So if you're not taking the necessary things you need to take with MDMA, like they recommend charcoal pills and what is that, B12 or something?
B12 complex.
Yeah, and you got to keep, like, you know, booting your immune system or you're going to fuck yourself up.
Well, I mean, like, just like with anything you ingest in your body, be responsible with it. You know, don't overdo anything, especially drugs. Do it in moderation.
Everything's good in moderation. Okay, let's talk about the panels we're on when we come back. I'll be high for those two.
I'm sure you will.
After excitedly posting an image of a Lamborghini red and tan Facebook,
What's the deal here, babe? We're the Rebel Love Show, and we're not smoking pot. When I saw that car, I was like, whoa. So you want to hand me, is there something in there? Or is there something in this one? You know, when you open up a grinder and you find enough pot in there for a bowl, it's like a little tiny miracle, especially it happened on the show.
I grinded this pot. I just never put it in there.
I know. It's like finding a 20 in your, like, jeans pocket. Like, oh, I still have some money. That's awesome. Sports cars are his favorite, and the picture of the bright yellow Lamborghini has already garnered 15 likes and 9 comments from other enthused middle-aged children who are friends with Weber on the social networking site. My best friend, he sent me so awesome. It has these big wheels, and he has a racing stripe. After watching several online videos of fast and eating a peanut butter and jelly sandwich for lunch, the homeowning little tyke went to his room to take a nap. Be careful scooting back.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure kids eat healthy, follow the 5 a day. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Could just mean a piece of fruit and a half cup of veggies. If you're picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources.
Hey.
Tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Picked up this, imagine someone for those watching at home, we picked up this great bubbler the other day. Oh, it's kind of it's fading through, but I'm loving this bubbler. It's fantastic. It's one of the best ones I've ever gotten. I've been on a search for this for years since I lost mine, like, way back in Chicago. I've been finding a piece like this, and I finally found it. Watch, it'll break in like a week.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like
you? Did you share this on our page?
Liberty activists are. Oh, I haven't even shared on the Facebook page yet. 85%
of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants, and they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move,
there's a fix
consider
for that.
Keen.
Fix for what?
For its civil disobedience and non-cooperation.
Hey, Kickstarter, a fix for what?
Political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of freekeen.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world,
oh,
with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here.
though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeen.com and get
Kickstarter saying take that before I smoke to help my tolerance. Is that what you're referring to here? That's freekeen. I know a lot of people say take eat mangoes right beforehand.
Things you can do for LRN.FM are 1. Let your friends know you're listening to LRN.FM on your social network.
I've always been meaning to be honest. I've heard so many people say that. I'm just too lazy to go get some.
$5 a month the AMP program at amp.lrn.fm. It's my firm belief that the AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented groups. Support all your favorite organizations, but make sure you get $5 a month.
I'm sorry, I know you want to go out there, and it doesn't like you, obviously.
This is your Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Tuesday, gold is even at $1,164 per ounce, and silver is even at $15.91 per ounce. Bitcoin is currently trading at $293. Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, a trusted name in precious metals since 1977. When you're serious about precious metals, give us a call at 800-874-9760 or visit us online at RRDI.
I wonder if we can get Riker on a panel with Jazzy Studio Dog.
Apparently
not. You're bringing this one back, babe.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Before we left, we were talking about all the drugs, but let's get back to Keenevention. We've mentioned several times, Rob thinks I'm going to be on the sexist panel, which is just the ladies panel. So we can talk about a lady's perspective of moving to the Shire.
What does it feel like to be on a, like you went to Keenevention last year as just a... As just a part, not a spectator, and now you're like participating in Keenevention.
Well, I can say, last year, I really liked Keenevention a lot. Like, it was my first like Liberty conference that I had went to. I wasn't dating Rob at the time, cause he broke up with me.
Sorry, baby doll. Can you ever forgive me for that?
No. So anyway, it was Keenevention. And I went with some more of my good friends. And, you know, it was just fun. We got drunk every morning, every evening, every afternoon. We went to panels. We sat together. We laughed. I thought the questions were great. I definitely felt like I learned a lot. I learned a lot about people. I met Renee there. I liked her a lot more then than I do now.
That's what a lot of people say about Renee.
Yeah, at this very moment. Like, it's the world's a difference. But, no, I mean, it's ironic. I met Ellen again. I met her other time. I had talked to her. And I talked to her there. And then now it's just like, here we are a year later. And now we're all doing like work together. We're all going to do a panel together. Like, I'm going to be on that panel. And I mean, honestly, I feel like I deserve a seat on the panel because I moved here and I started doing stuff. Like, and you can't like discount that. You know, I try to be active. I try to volunteer. I try to do what I can to, you know, just be a part of the community and maybe inspire some people and get some more people to move here. So, I mean, I feel like going to the panels, that's what inspired me to do those things. So maybe if I can be on it and talk about my journey to, you know, moving here and trying to make it count, then maybe it'll inspire more people to move here. So I feel like it's definitely a lot has changed in just 1 year.
Oh my
and
God,
I think that's
yes.
just like a triumph in itself. Like I'm not the same person I was back then.
We don't even look like the same people.
We don't even look like the same people. We look like just like younger, like innocent versions of ourselves. I don't
just
know.
Like looking at the photos of us from like last Keenevention.
Better or worse?
Oh, we look tenfold better.
Oh my God, so much better.
Yeah, I mean, back then I was like clean shaved and.
You had your little weird pointy hair going on.
Did I at Keenevention? No, I didn't.
Yeah.
At Liberty Forum I did.
No, oh, at Keenevention you just had long hair. You had.
I didn't really have long hair. Did
yeah,
I?
You had those bangs.
Well, it's long compared to what I got now. Now it's like, you know, it's like biker gang member short.
That's a
right
good
now.
Amount of short. But you have like longer hair. And, you know, you didn't really have a beard.
Oh, I love my beard now.
Exactly.
Like, it's become like an iconic image of
me. Oh my God, like you're so much hotter than you were back then.
You think so?
Yeah, like I definitely do you now.
Well, you definitely did me then, so I'm glad I didn't need the beard back then.
Exactly. I'm just saying, like, if there was any ever doubt in my mind, it would be gone.
You know, I've told myself plenty of times, even from before I got grew this beard out till now, the moments, no, don't get me wrong, babe, I'm doing it for you. I've kept it this long for you. There's been multiple days I wanted to shave it off. But I told myself if I couldn't sell my day job,
babe, I'm helping you sell.
I'm a salesperson, I need to sell. If I couldn't sell without a beard, I'm with
this beard. I'm helping
you
sell. You know what makes beards grow. So women associate beards with aura. anyway, I mean, Keenevention definitely was a changing point in my life, so I'll always consider it very, very special. Now, something I'm very disappointed about, because I feel like I may be a fangirl, or I don't know, maybe I wasn't really expecting something. Something like this to happen, I guess. But the Keen Activist Center is no more.
Yeah, it's now SLAP.
Excuse me?
Oh, God, I forgot the acronym. It's a Rich Paul thing now.
Can you tell me more about this Rich Paul thing? Anyway, the Keen Activist Center... featured in Derek J's victimless crime spree. Very sacred, but it was a place that I share a lot of memories in, a lot of memories that got me adjusted to living in New Hampshire and starting my life here as not just an activist, but doing podcasts. And I feel like the Keen Activist Center was a part of that. And it was just like somewhere... like, no matter what you thought about Keen, like, I always thought, like, the Keen Activist Center was a cool place, and it would inspire future movers to want to move, even if not to Keen, just want to move, because there's so much history that happened there. But apparently, it is no more, and it's called something...
It is the Society for Love and Peace is now open in the real estate formerly known as the CAC. It is an outreach center for the Church of the Invisible Hand the shaman or priest himself, none other than Rich Paul.
It's no longer a membership organization. And as someone who was once a member...
technically, you can go now anytime you want. There's no admission charge for monthly charge. So come on by.
I guess... But I just don't understand, like, the purpose of closing the CAC. You know, I've always joked, Keen is dead, Keen, nothing's gonna, Keen, blah, blah, blah. But I didn't really mean it.
You didn't, you talked about that all the time.
I mean, I guess I meant it, but, you know, I still thought, you know, the CAC was a bit of hope, because that was there. So, you know, Keen's always gonna be alive. There anymore.
You know what's weird? Like, I always kind of, that here after the heyday of Keen. Like, I feel like I got here way after the heyday, you know, and you're talking about, like, your memories of Keen and stuff like that. Like, I feel as if, like, we both missed, like, the boats in regards to, like, the heyday.
I didn't think the boat was going to sink that fast.
I would say it's still, you know, there's still people doing things, just different people doing different things aren't as public as they once were.
Okay, no, I'm not saying people aren't doing things. I'm not necessarily saying that's the case. I think people are doing things, and I think that's great. But I also think, like, having the CAC, just like as we have things in Manchester and things in Portsmouth that, like, symbolize and, like, are for the activists who are coming there. For me, like, I missed the heyday of Keen, but it was like walking in a museum of that.
And I never thought of it that way.
Yeah, and now they've closed that museum, and they're just some slap now. Like, it's just, I don't know, some kind of joke of themselves. Like, it's kind of like they let, you know, the free Keeners win. I mean, I know they're going to still have
Would
the church.
Would you say stop free Keen
stop free, I mean, I know they're still going to have the church there, and I think that's great. You know, there's pastors, and there's people who come there, but I don't know. Having no CAC?
It's one thing I've learned and seen since before I moved. Cause I used to pay attention to this scene way before I moved. And since being here, there's waves. there's like these waves of people that come in, they go into different areas of the state. There might be a resurrection in Keene. Who knows? You know, maybe there might be an exodus. I mean, right now there's a decent population in Manch, but who knows? There might be an exodus to like the seacoast or up to Concord or something like that. Like, that's a possibility that could happen too.
That is a possibility, but it's a toss up because people, like, the thing is, people aren't like, we aren't on our last leg. So if that was something to happen, it'd be, that shocked everyone. You'd be like, oh, like the fact that this cat closing wasn't a shock, that it should have been.
I know.
It should have been.
I know Rich Paul wants to have me talk to him about it. I wouldn't mind having on the show to talk about it, where he wants to go over like the what worked and what didn't during the heyday and what lessons can be learned thereof, like what can we take from what worked and what didn't, and you know, reapply that to like activists for the future.
So I know you're like Mr. Optimistic, but you don't see this as kind of the end of Keene. This, the exit has happened, and this is the end.
It'll be the end of Keene. The day, even when like even when the day comes where, like,
now that's just like the LRN headquarters.
The entire CAC gets, like, you know, taken by the state, which I don't think is going to be for years and years if that ever even does happen, which I highly doubt it will at this point. But even if that happened, LRN would be replaced somehow somewhere else in the state or something like that. Free Talk Live would still take place. Like, it's,
I mean, maybe. You know. I mean, I'd hope so. But
it definitely will.
Who knows? It was a bad idea. I don't understand
what it.
It
used to be, but
it
could be a birth of something brand new with the Church of the Invisible Hand.
I don't support this. I think it's ridiculous. More when we come back.
Since time began, tyrants have
pack another ball bin. Oh, this is a long break, by the way. Right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read. Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you're dirty. On your knees.
What's the problem, officer? Today, to enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around. Yo. I was an undercover narcotics. We're actually technically on the long break. We're on the break till Wow. Yeah. No, we're on break till 11:06. It's the long break. You can come in and wave at the camera. That camera's live right now. Right there. Right
Joe
there.
Joe says hi, everyone.
Yeah, Joe says hi to the LRN chat if you're watching live. Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Yeah, I haven't done the that's Carlos. Last week he was on. He was doing his impersonation of Carlos Santana. But he jumped down and played guitar. Now, you guys are supposed to do some hush-hush secret, not-so-secret project. That's what he was saying. Yeah. Is that news to you? That wasn't what I was referring to. Something about recording. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime, on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for lrn.fm in the Android app. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media. Yeah, but, that's why the amps there. He was jamming on the show last week.
apps.lrn.fm.
That's apps.lrn.fm. Oh, okay.
Cat, K-A-C. That, I literally spelled it. That's retarded.
What? It's not the CAC anymore. You know that, right?
It's the nothing.
Slap.
It's
like, that's a horrible
mockery.
Acronym, slap.
Like, what? Like, what the fuck is that? That's sad.
I don't know. Yeah, next thing you know, the quill is going to be called the Q, and then it's just going to be called that place, and and then place or a letter or just be a sound.
Oh,
Oh, I don't know. An aha sound? Or like maybe a coughing sound? Be a cough after you take a heavy hit off of a bowl. But yeah, this new, I got this piece at Good Times on Elm. It's a bubbler. What?
Nice.
You what now? Oh, well. Lucky you.
Oh, someone posted the one of the freaking Stop Freaking Nice comments. They won. Turkey appears to believe a larger YPG. Way to go out like a pussy.
Yeah, the CAC. We're debating the CAC as in like now it's gone. And how there's Nexus and blah 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 blah. For precious metals, bitcoins, or books, you'll find that and more at shop.lpbradio.com. Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates, like Namecheap and it is what it is.
Dang, someone just said the bulldozer comes through next and knocks down the flop house and the general all around eyesore from the neighborhood. Yeah. That's, I think his name is Neighbor 62.
It is kind of crazy walking outside the street here and running into porks all the time. I know. It's like I walk every time I go to my car, I see one. Yeah. This is Pork Central. Yeah. You know, it's weird at work. I've told people, because they'll see my car and stuff like that. It's like, if you see a porcupine sticker on their car, like, I probably know them or may know of them or some sort of fashion or another. And, like, a sales rep has started to pay attention. It's like, I see fucking pork stickers all over the place. Like, I see these porcupine cars, like, everywhere. Have you seen this car, that car? He'll start asking me about these cars. Oh, you know what? Because I had three tickets at Pork Fest, so one of them I threw on the car, but the other one's on the fridge. So yeah, if I only had one, like I had the previous year, which is also on the fridge, that never made it to my car. Having a duplicate, I was okay with putting it on my car. I want to buy one of those just yellow porcupine stickers. Does he? I just saw him this morning. Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, if you could.
Riker, come on. Don't be a dick.
Yeah, you can leave her out. Or if she comes in, she comes in. Yeah, babe, I was pulling you because you were like, you weren't much on camera. That's why I was pulling you. Like, it's a small field from this. Like, it doesn't have a large shot. Hey, Amanda, if you really do watch the show, tell me what you think of this bubbler. Do you think it looks cool? This is a test to see if you actually watch. And Marcus, too. Yeah. She said she watched. I'm just curious if she really does.
This has been FPP Radio News. Online at fppradio.com. Everyone in a bustling Chinese parade attempting to newly discovered cave paintings suggest early man was battling a lot of inner and a xylophone is shredding it.
This Tuesday, FBI officials disclosed details of a disturbing Al-Qaeda plot to just kick back, relax, and savor the inevitable collapse of the United States.
Intelligence. Am I bringing it back, or you? Whose turn is it?
I think it's my turn.
Okay. What are we coming back with?
Whatever I just left off with.
It's hard to remember, babe.
Well, I remember, so where was it?
The CAC and SLAP.
Environmental self-destruction gradually tear the nation apart.
Our righteous warriors will devote our time to relaxing and really soaking in the infidel. America's cities will be reduced to ruins. The economy will come to a standstill. And we, the blessed of Islam, will kick, put our feet up, and enjoy the show. It's going to be great.
This is the Onion News Network.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. Before we left, we were discussing my total outrage and just shock that the KAC is no more and it is now the SLAP. I do repeat, the SLAP, the Society of For Love and Peace.
I will say this, like, I'm not a fan of the acronym. Of SLAP.
I mean, I'm not a fan of the whole thing. I would hope, I have hope
that church.
We'll get new movers. And as we see, as we go to all these new mover parties, there are new people coming every time. Every time we go, there's
I know,
a new
every
mover.
Time we go to new mover parties, there's like dozens of other 80%. New people I've never met before.
I think, if you can quote me on this, I think we're 80%. I think I was scrolling through Facebook and I seen a post that we're 80%. On the way
to
there
the signers.
To,
no, it's like actually goal. I think at 88% or something like that.
Yeah. It's really high. Pretty high. And you know, you got people moving here every day, and I think that was one of the reasons, like, especially for me, I thought it was very historical that the CAC was there, and that was what was going to keep Keen alive. Now, well, I'm just like,
a lot of history went down through the CAC.
Exactly.
You know, Cop Block was born out of that, you know, with the Damo and Pete Eyre, and it got you know, Derek Chase, victimless crime spree coming out of there.
Yeah, the raid, the famous raid of like the KAC, and it was still standing after all of that, and now it's gone. You know.
Yeah, I know. It's still sad. There. The building's still there. The people that are still going there to the CAC
the
are still going to
is
to the
still
slab.
There, but
I
it's
wonder,
not the same.
I wonder if Stop Free Keen will turn into. I wonder if they'll turn into the Stop the Slap movement.
Stop the Slap?
Yeah, Stop the Slap.
I mean,
someone needs to make a Facebook page for that.
One of the comments, because someone in the chat sent it to me, is just someone saying, oh my God, I wish, good thing the CAC is closing. I'd like a bulldozer to come knock down that ugly eyesore of a house next, that cult. Fucking what was the other word they used?
Okay, I will say this, as someone who is, I get where people say it's culty from the outside, but I mean it's a voluntary like association of like-minded individuals. You know, I wouldn't say it is a cult. Like a lot of people in the compare people in the liberty movement as people being in a cult.
I think
it's not that at all. It's just that you're being around other people that think like you. That's all it is. I mean, pretty much any that with that kind of logic, it's pretty much any group of associating people
is a cult.
Yeah,
because
it's a bunch of people that are together. You know, that
thinking
have a mindset of the same
and trying to force you to think like them. That's
yeah.
The
only difference is this one. If this is a cult, they don't force you to do anything.
Yeah,
in fact, that is literally their religious edict of the nap. Like, you don't fuck with anybody else, and you're golden, almost to the T. To the point where like there are situations that normally wouldn't take place among smuggles.
Yeah, yeah, because you know most smuggles resort to violence because that's all they know. But anyway, so yep. I mean, they're calling it fraud or shithole and all of this stuff, and it just is sad because the Stop Free Keeners won.
I wouldn't say they won.
Feel like they won.
If
this is the battle, they definitely lost this battle. They should be still standing strong. 20 years from now, they should say this is the KA motherfucking C, and there's so much amazing things that took place here. I mean, I guess the church. But what if people, like, attaching religion to things is not always the best idea. Because people don't like the idea of religion. They don't like the sound of religion. And whatever, how awesome your religion may be or what have you, people still push people away from it.
You know what's awesome about religions? They get tax exempt from the state.
I mean, yeah.
That is like more than a reason to start your own church for any reason. You know, people here, there should be a movement of people in New Hampshire that should start a church where, like, they literally are blatant about it. They're like, yeah, we're the church of tax exempt, and we feel that everyone that's a part of our church should be tax exempt.
and they can congregate in their own homes.
Yeah, they can all be ministers of their own homes.
Tax exempt God.
Yes.
I think it's awesome. Like, I'm not downplaying their church by any means, but you have to see how this is kind of taking a hit for them, because, like, the Keen Activist Center, it's a name that means something, and doing away with that name, I just don't think is smart. I don't think that's a good idea.
Well, I won't.
And turning into something that's, like, involving a religion, and no matter what kind of religion it is, that's going to push people away, like, because on the surface, you're going to be a church. Like, no matter what you're trying to spread, you're going to be a church, and that won't sit with some people.
What if the church actually gets, what if they, as they're running it now, what if this is more successful than the CAC? Will you eat your words? Will you say I'm wrong on radio?
I would, but I personally wouldn't be joining their church.
Why not?
I
thought you're a high priestess of, like, every other church under the sun.
I am, but those churches aren't real.
Yeah, they are. They're really real. Those are, and you're really a priestess.
Yes, I mean, I guess, but I'm not downplaying their church again. Like, good for them, go church. But I, like you said, I'm always the high priestess of enough churches, and I just like the idea of the Keen Activist Center being somewhere where members could go, they could congregate. It's like their safe place.
It's,
like, they can go and
really,
like, think
same,
of history.
It's the same thing with a different name now. That's really the case. It's more of a rebranding.
From a marketing perspective,
I don't like the marketing, but I like the idea behind them.
From
behind
a
the idea of marketing, it needed a rebranding.
Companies rebrand and they drop names the opposite way. They rebrand from religion, not to religion. That is never a rebrand in history.
How does a company rebrand from religion? What does that even mean?
For instance, I work for a company who had a religious title. No, there are plenty examples like that. There are plenty examples of companies with, like, religious names, such as something with Lutheran in it. They'd remove that name and change their name to something different because they don't want people not coming there. There has been companies throughout history because people associate religion with something judgmental. It's just what it is. It is what it is. It doesn't matter what kind of church it is. People don't rebrand to make themselves more religious.
Well, I will say this in regards to porcupines and religion. It's kind of like testing the waters of being able to practice whatever religion you want to practice. And it's almost even Church of the Sword is, that's a created religion. And yeah, they're...
Yeah, and I support them. But Church of the Sword didn't take the Keen Activist Center and make it Church of the Sword.
Yeah, but it was taken by CAC members. It's being used by the same people that were using it prior to. It's literally just a rebranding. It's not like the ownership or anything like that. To me, it's just nothing more than a rebranding. And in honesty, it's a right marketing move. I just don't like the marketing name. I don't think Slap is the correct name
for the marketing.
Marketing it as something different.
I totally disagree. They should be marketing it as a Keen Activist Center and not the Slap in this religious institution. No matter how much
it's
you can
say, it's a society for love and peace.
Whatever. No matter how much you're saying, like, it's no different what you'd like to believe, it's gonna make a difference in the long run.
I will say I love the logo of the Society for Love and Peace. For those listening to LRN, it's a yin yang sign, but it's in ANCAP colors, and it's a heart and a peace logo on the top.
They named themselves Slap. Like, what the fuck is that? Slap?
It's the Society for Love and Peace.
Is that for real?
It's provocative. It's eye-catching.
Are you for real? Anyway, so that's what's going on with that, which is going to make convention really, really interesting because I remember last Keenevention, my first time going to the KAC.
Oh, yeah, it was your first time?
It was my first time.
At the CAC,
yep, yeah. I ate the VIP dinner. I got the grand tour. It was amazing. And ever since then, I guess I've held the CAC to a higher standard than they held themselves, apparently. So I don't know.
That was so awkward when I remember being there at the CAC with you.
Oh, yeah.
That was before we got back together. That was really awkward.
Yeah, because you're a dick. Anyway, more when we come back.
Want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor.
Okay, what was this question? People don't like the idea of religion. I guess religious people aren't people. No, I'm not saying they aren't people, though there are some people, but people who are trying to move for the purpose of activism may be strayed by the fact that this is now a religious cause. That is all I'm saying. I guess religious people are people. I suppose. I don't think they're aliens. I haven't tested their DNA. So, troll on,
bitches.
Breakthroughs in energy, health, and computer science. Learn with wealth admitted to in the lame media. Corporate media. For the distributors of government propaganda, but now there's an alternative.
Freedomsphoenix.com. The issues that affect your life. We need a commercial like this. With liberty and
property under why do you keep saying that about every commercial?
No, we need something different, a completely different sound. Like, we need a. Freedomsphoenix.com. That's freedoms with an S.
Phoenix.com. FreedomsPhoenix.com. Today is the day Keen died. Rest in peace, Keen. Rest in peace.
Today's the day he died?
No. The day they announce this is the day Keen died.
It's the day Keen died.
Mark my word. Add this number to your phone. 213-493-0309. It's a long distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Liberty Radio Network listen lines are locked into our stream 24 hours a day. Call 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309. I hate the thumbnail that it auto did. Ugh, what is up with my face?
Why
did
you? Why did I look down? You need to be looking at the camera like, you know, you need to pay attention to what's on here. You need to look pretty 24/7 when you're on this. You can't be doing it because people are going to take screenshots of you and start memeing you and like that. You know. Oh.
Thanks for giving them my idea.
Oh, they already got that advice. They already knew. Yeah, take a meme of these right here. Take a meme of those guys.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards
the same thing. Oh, we got to talk about the vape shit.
Oh, yeah. We got a lot of show prep. Ha, told ya.
Vaping. And for
let's talk about vaping next, and then we can move into something else.
I do want to talk about the Uber stuff, and we still kind of want to talk about the panels.
Well, we got... I thought we talked about the panels.
No, we talked about the sexist panel. Cop block panel. Tech panel, secession panel.
Those are all your panels, James.
Is there any more pot left? Okay, can you grind some, babe? Home and garden, bed and bath,
furniture, kitchen, pet supplies. You're mad needy, bro.
I know. That's why you love me, though. Sports and outdoors, toys,
games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.lrn.fm. Get all your shopping done. Get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit the Liberty Radio Network. When you shop at Amazon via shop.lrn.fm.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop their money. There is an alternative.
I can't wait to see
Bitcoin
Derek here.
Bitcoin is a stateless, market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you are helping.
It's gonna be so weird to meet this Steven guy. I feel
you
like I know.
Steven.
When did I meet it? We didn't meet
at
Porkfest.
Pork
yeah, he was at Porkfest. I don't remember talking to him.
That's he's Bitcoin. Awesome. You'll like him.
If you enjoy, but I know, I'm just saying, I know him beautiful. By, I know him by so many, like, mostly nude photos of him on Facebook.
You feel like you're
I feel like I know him.
Yeah.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. And we were talking about the CAC earlier, but I kind of want to bring it up to what's going on with vaping in the news. I want to go on my little rant here.
He's a vape enthusiast, so.
Yeah. I'm not an enthusiast. I would say I'm a novice. I learn enough just so I can vape. Like, I'm like have a break at work so I can go out and instead of smoking a cigarette, which I don't want to do, I can vape. And I enjoy vaping on the show and if I'm working on content or something like that. But that's basically the extent of me vaping. But I do enjoy the nicotine to it. I don't want to have a cigarette in my mouth.
And you just think you're cool.
I don't know. I don't think I'm cool. I know I'm cool.
Anywho, what's the news in vaping?
The FDA is going after, basically wanting to regulate and like retroactively regulate pretty much any vape juice and stuff like that out on the market. The cost in doing that is going to be huge to most vape. I mean, so many companies that are basically startups in the vape world. The vape world is still, like, for the most part, a new industry.
I mean,
so there's a lot of startup companies, but it's not like huge established brand names and stuff.
So, I mean, we read this article on Fortune.com. Yeah, Fortune.com. And they are going to be taxing it as if it's a cigarette. So, like, your vape pens that you buy, they'll now, like, have an extra cigarette tax on them.
It's horrible. I mean, like, it's not something that should be even...
The government wants to control everything you do down to the very last puff.
I mean,
because why? If what is the argument for this? Like, why would someone say
you might
get
cancer? You might die of cancer because there might be cancer. Is be some sort of cancerous chemical in the vape that will kill you in like 30 or 40 years from now, or something along those lines.
Okay, and
they
want to
make
sure
that those aren't in there, but in the scheme
if
of
you
things,
stand in front of a microwave, you could probably get cancer. When are
they just like bacon cancer? Like, I mean, who
this fucking grinder is gonna cause cancer?
Like
everything's gonna give you cancer. Dunkin' Donuts, like wooden spoon. I don't know, but at this point, they're just so
even
they
if
need
it
to
does,
tax
even
it,
if it
so
does.
That it stops like. So it stops you from getting cancer somehow? Like, how are you buying that fucking logic? They want to tax it so it helps you in the long run.
They're buying that logic because the big tobacco industry does not want vape pens to exist. They don't want people vaping.
They do. They want to make money off of
the thing. All right, they already realize that they're not gonna the war against vaping.
No.
So why not take it over? Big tobacco. Are loaded, easily release like you know their own branded vape pens and stuff like that,
which is what they're doing,
and they can afford to pay off the regulations and stuff. The smaller like you know independent vape shops that have their own regional juices, they're not going to be able to do all these applications and stuff like that for the FDA. They're literally not going to be able to afford it. They're going to be you know sued out of existence, stuff like that. Like it's
oh no, they're gonna be all regulations. You know, this FDA warning on the bottle. Like they're gonna make them jump through hoops so that they get eyes on it first of all, and second of all, just take it over because they want to control you. They want to control everything you do. They want a cut. They always want their cut.
Well, that's what this is all about.
This is what it's all.
From my perspective, it's really two things. It has nothing to do with saving lives. Nothing ever. Regards to laws,
it could
they
possibly
really don't.
Maybe one day give you cancer.
It's literally about control and who can give them more money. And in the grand scheme of things, like the big tobacco can't afford it, and they're winning the political war against the vaping industry. Like they are continuing to have success. I mean, it's going to get to a point where vaping is a civil disobedience. In some places, it is. There's places. I believe in New York and LA, not LA, but New York and Blue Chicago as well. Like it is a crime to be vaping in public. Like, you have to go, like, to assigned areas in certain cities and stuff.
Like, are they mentally incapacitated? It makes sense. It's vapor.
I know. It's water vapor that is exhaled. I mean, their argument is that breathing can cause some different lung disease and maybe
I'm sure,
like that.
I'm sure, but drinking tap water.
Everything does. I mean, if that's the case,
same argument.
Yeah, it's really ridiculous, and it's state, and it's just one thing that they're going after.
What are we gonna do to protest this? Like, is this
vaping
this is a,
somewhere?
This is a bill, or has it passed?
No,
like,
it's an FDA. I mean, that they're trying to push through. And,
so
but
it's
the grand scheme
a,
of things, there's always new.
They're giving.
Well, it's more than just the FDA, but a lot of localities, even New Hampshire, is trying to ban vaping in bars and stuff like that. It hasn't gone through yet.
I mean,
they're trying.
Any law that comes on the bill that's like anti-vape, we just need to go and like plan some kind of diss and protest, make some signs like, how is this water vapor? I don't know. Something, because we can't just let this stand.
I know
if
we should
do,
do
nothing, and then they just win. And I can't do that. We're not going down like
if
that.
If there is a pro vaping thing legal, you can actually do multiple things at the same time. You can be a pro vaping, like, you know, civil dis, and you can do this in some areas. But what if you're open carrying and you know signs, you're doing free speech. It's just free speech, open carry, pro vape.
It's
be the
just,
first of its kind.
It's just a shame that it has to go to that length. It has like level, because they're literally saying that this could possibly maybe one day give you so we think you should pay a little bit extra for your cancer, and hope to buy it.
Well, you know what?
Just,
here's the
a
thing.
A plus B just
a lot of the taxing, the taxation that the government nannies did. Cigarettes, in all honesty, pretty much created the vape industry as an alternative, as a cheap alternative than buying cigarettes. Because taxation, especially in like major metropolitan cities, you know, I remember in Chicago, $13 for a fucking pack of cigarettes, which was outrageous.
I think it's like $8.
I'm like shocked by the price of it. It's always like $5 less than I would expect to pay for cigarettes. You know, and it's gotten to the point where that's why vaping is a thing, because companies really came out of being as a way to get nicotine cheaper than smoking.
I mean, and as I read the article, you know how like in cigarettes, they're like, oh, all this bad and nicotine are going to happen to you. This is your future. Like, cigarettes will cause cancer, absolutely, and you'll die. Like, that's just like a given. Vaping argument is, oh, we don't know. It could possibly maybe be dangerous. So to step in and regulate it. So send us all your vape juice. And get tied up. They're basically shakedown. They're murdering the industry right now. We're watching the vape industry be murdered by the federal government.
Yeah, if they got to pay their dues, if they can't, they'll go out of business. They're not paying their local protection racket.
It's gross. I about protesting and cop block, maybe. What about more when we come back?
Keenevention is coming up fast, October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenevention.info. Keenevention is an intimate event where you can meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire, including Oathkeeper Chris Reitman, Libertarian presidential candidate Daryl W. Perry, illegal Uber driver Christopher David, NeoCash Radio's Dr. Darren Tapp, State Representative Mike Sylvia, rated an A+ by the NHLA, the Seditious Sirens, the Rebel Love Show's Rob Mathias, tech guru Brian Sovereign, cop blocker J.P. Freeman, new mover Dr. Taryn Lupo, longtime political activist Dennis Goddard, Church of the Invisible Hand minister Rich Paul, Shire Dude, and dozens more. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallowkeen costume dance party. Reserve your tickets now at keenevention.info.
Visit Keenevention.info for more speaker announcements, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's Keenevention.info.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it, but here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org to get started.
Did you know you can listen to LRN.fm via our free
air
satellite
channels?
To
bring back, you take it back to whatever
you want. We have channels over nearly all of North America.
I do
want to
talk about the liberation shit.
All you need is an affordable receiver and a dish as small as 30 inches. There are no monthly fees. Learn more at sat.lrn.fm. Plus, if you are a broadcaster or want to be one,
actually regret buying these chairs.
For our content. See our coverage maps and details at sat.lrn.fm.
They're like great chairs, but they're almost too big for. They're really comfortable though, but they're too big.
You know, I feel like we need a different camera angle.
When from where?
Someone keeps stopping.
Like, I'd like to put this camera on a tripod or something.
He or she were and what, had it coming down at us?
On something
avoid
else.
Doing that.
Well,
it's
well, even for my web, if I
and it imposes upon the listener
angles.
To help
okay.
you complete the and if seeker this.
So you think this is too close? This is actually far back compared to what we normally. We're normally like right up here instead of back here.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like it's fine. I don't know.
Oh, don't do this.
Effective communication skills have never
yeah,
been
chairs
more
are definitely
important.
Too big.
Cutting through
you know what I really don't like about the chairs? Mm-hmm. And I hope the mic doesn't pick it up. That
will help you connect
like just moving around in them, it's like loud.
Yeah.
For more tips, hit survival speech.
I didn't even think about that.
I'm Holland Cook.
Nice
Survivalspeech.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm.
I don't even have an LR Instagram account. I need to put one on.
LRN.fm.
And welcome back to the Rebel Love Show. I forgot what I was pissed off about before we left. But here's what we're coming back to. So I know a while ago we mentioned the MAC tours, which MAC stands for.
Mobile Accountability for Cops.
Thanks for catching that. So it was a demo. Did I make that his name right?
A demo.
A demo. Who's the founder of Cop Blog? He went on this tour with who? Who else?
Brian and a few other cop blockers.
And I remember a while ago we said it, and Rob was said, I'm excited to see where this tour is going to go. It's great to see activism like this. So this tour has gone to jail, which, come on, let's be honest. We all knew it would probably.
It's for ridiculous reasons.
It's for more so ridiculous. It's so petty. I was like, I was sure it was going to be something more substantial than this, but
yeah. So if you go to freekeen.com, Ian has a post on it. It's a demo. Basically, he was arrested in Kansas for a warrant that was issued for his arrest in Indiana when they were chalking the police station.
Okay, let's go back. Where did they start the MAC tour?
I believe it was in Ohio.
How many states did they make it through before they were arrested?
I made it to Kansas.
I'm not very geographical.
Where? Ohio, Indiana, Illinois, Missouri, Kansas.
How many states? Like, how many is it? I didn't count. Sorry, you were listening too fast, and I'm kind of drunk.
It's okay, babe. At any rate, they went through a few states.
Oh, my God. So, anyway, my point was they went through about five states before they were just arrested. And they were touring just all the states. Was that the goal, to get to all 50 or what?
They're going to hit multiple different areas around the country. I don't know if they're going to hit all 50 states, but they're going to hit, like, a lot of different hotbeds.
I mean, they have been gone for, I feel like this just happened recently, but, you know, it's Shire time.
I know. Something that happened like a week ago feels like it was a month ago. It feels like old news. If you don't see it like immediately, it just feels like old news.
I know he was arrested 10 days ago, and they turned themselves in, but they are not asking for bail money, as I hear it correctly.
No, because they don't want to give.
Can you read exactly what it says, or can I read it? Where is it?
I don't have the article exactly why they're not doing it, but I know why they're not doing it. They don't want to give the state any money. So they don't want to be bailed out of jail because they don't want to give the state more money. On top of that, they want to face their charges now and get it over with instead of dragging that farther down with a bail to be bailed out. Because then they would have to come back anyways, and there's limitations to being on bail.
They're both charged with criminal mischief. And they they're going to spend several weeks. Was it 6 months, I think?
Yeah, apparently, like something along the lines where their case isn't going to be like possibly 6 months, where they could sit in a jail now until have their trial.
And I think they're
for chalking.
For chalking, yeah.
For literally putting chalk on.
Chalk on the ground. When it rains, it can wash off. You know, you can piss on it and it'll wash off. Like, I don't know. But apparently, this is not good enough for. Where are they again?
They're in Indiana.
The Indiana State Police. They
sheriff's
need to
department.
Sheriff's
department. I forget which one. Hamilton County Sheriff's Department.
Hamilton fucking County Sheriff's Department. They need to make a statement and keep them in jail. First of all, this is what your money is going toward. Someone drawing on the ground with chalk is going to sit in a jail cell for 6 months. For 6 months. Like, this is what your money is going towards.
No,
being stolen for.
It's incredible to see, like, you know, even people who are police officers, people that work for this, hell, people that love the state, were prisons created to put people in there for literally chalking on, you know, literally taking a piece of chalk, writing it on the ground, practicing their First Amendment rights to voice up their opinion against the oppression that they see, and are. Their punishment is to be kidnapped and put in a cage for months on end. Were prisons created for that?
And if you don't see the correlation between the Irwin Schiff, he literally died in prison for paying a tax, for not paying a tax. And I quote, when no law says that you have to. Can you point me to the law that says, like drawing on the ground with liquid chalk is an offense to the law?
Even if there is a law, if someone wrote down on a piece of paper, all right, that you can or cannot do something, if there is no victim, there's no victim, there's no crime. The only victim of the crime is the person who committed the crime. It's not a fucking crime. All right, there's no logical sense that can even take place. So when people say, like, well, you know, they broke the law. Like, well, the law probably meant to be broken. It shouldn't have been a law to begin with.
I mean, every law should be broken, personally.
Every law, babe, every law should be broken.
If it's a law, I mean, within reason, I guess, but...
I mean, some laws make sense. I'm not advocating that there be laws, but some laws, like, you know, don't, you know, against robbery and murder and rape, I'm down for those.
Wait, really? So you think people are just sitting around like,
no.
oh, Thank God there's a law that says I can't murder you. You would be so dead right now.
Oh my God.
If that's the truth, then murder and rape wouldn't exist. Murder and rape still exist. Laws don't change that. It doesn't, just because something's written, don't kill people. That is not the reason I'm not murdering you right now.
I remember.
It's because I have a decency and a soul, and I think most human beings do.
I got into this whenever I get into these huge religious conversational pieces, usually with like Jehovah's Witnesses or something like that, I'll swing it back at them, and I tried to wake them up from the state, like they're trying to wake me up to be a Jehovah's Witness. So like, it's like we're pulling jabs back and forth and like trying to win each other over. And I got this guy. He literally says he does everything because it's written down in the Book of Jehovah, whatever, blah, blah, blah. I was like, what about laws? Like, why do you practice laws? And his whole thing was saying, yeah, I don't break laws because it's written down. I'm like, so if it wasn't written down that you cannot kill me, that you should not kill me, you would do it? And he says, well, I don't know. It's not written down. Like, he literally was so brainwashed that he had to have something written down to tell him how to be a good human being.
I mean, exactly. And I think that proves my point. So when you say, you know, I'm not advocating for there being no laws, I mean, I am, because I think people are smart enough to make their own decisions, and that's one reason I believe in anarchy.
I am 100% for no laws. I'm just saying there are some laws
that make sense, that make sense and obvious,
even though I don't think they should exist, because it's so obvious to anyone that you shouldn't do that.
I mean,
you know, wrong is wrong, and right is right.
One, on another show, he could go through the law books or whatever. But I think just the difference is who gets to carry out these laws. And if you think the police or whoever, the government should have so much authority over you that they can literally keep you in a cage for drawing on a sidewalk with chalk, then you're a bit ridiculous. Like, I don't know how else to put that. You're just a bit ridiculous.
No, I completely get what you're saying. But anyways, with the cop lockers here in jail for the MAC tour, they don't want any donations for their cases here. However, if you do feel like donating, you can actually go to coplock.org, click on MAC tour. You can contribute to the fund there, because they do plan to continue that once they are released.
Unless they're like earned shift there.
Nah, they're not.
Sit in jail.
I will say this. Like, I hope neither one of us ever gets arrested. I don't want to get arrested.
I mean, I don't want to get arrested either. I just want to wake people up, because I feel like this is ridiculous.
Now,
I feel like if I went across the street with all my chalk and wrote on the sidewalk, robbed a piece of shit, and then you took me in and dragged me and beat me and locked me in a cage, that'd be wrong of you.
No, you would have had it coming, because why would you ever speak ill will of me out on the streets?
Well, more when we come back.
Free Talk Live.
This is the first time I've heard your program. I'm hearing this person talk about what a wonderful thing it would be if we had legal drugs.
Yes,
I don't know
Sandy.
Where you're getting your
information. I want legal drugs too.
You lost your mind.
No. Not lost my mind.
You don't want to hear.
I want all the drugs legal.
Reality. Okay.
Please.
Well,
knock me over with reality,
like
Sandy.
A 12-year-old, you know? I'm telling you what about the war on drugs.
I do kind of incorporate Skype calls at some point.
Man, look,
I gotta figure that shit out.
Treatment center, lady.
Oh, good for her.
There you go.
Good for her.
Sandy, okay. I've smoked.
Because if it was just working on one computer, we'd be able to do it easily. It's the fact that we have to, it's on two PCs that, like, makes shit complicated. I can easily get it to go out to LRN. I can easily get it to go out to YouTube. But getting the audio to go to both, that's a hard thing to do. Hopefully Derek can show me on Thursday.
I'd Robert like to call into LRN.
Early trading Tuesday, gold is even at 11.
I mean, Free Talk Live.
You should one day.
I should call in. When is the next Free Talk Live show?
You're killing me, babe. You're killing me. Free Talk Live is on every night.
At 7?
It's on at yes, 7 Eastern for 3 hours.
Well, I'm going to call tomorrow and here's a just voice to do a my activism displeasure. While
you're
Facebook, Twitter, or
Google Plus. Between the okay. You're going to Skype in, though. You're not going to call in. You're going to Skype in.
Yeah, I'm going to Skype in. Free Talk
Live's post. You know, I actually Skyped in to Free Talk Live the night I went down to celebrate with you in Boston.
Wait, what did
you say? It was like a month before you moved. No, it was like 2 weeks before you moved. And Jeff was there. We went out, and you talk about how we got kicked out of clubs, blah blah blah.
Yeah.
Okay. I called Free Talk Live via Skype on my phone while I was driving.
And I was there.
Nope. Oh, no, it was on the way there. To see you. Yeah.
Oh yeah, I remember you telling me that.
Yeah, that was the last time I think I ever called in. It's been a while. I'm usually busy when they're on. I never listen to it live. I know Kickstarter. I see that. Yeah. Welcome to my world. That's like a normal occurrence from time to time. It's see, I'm not the only one that was like,
oh. Why?
You should know Free Talk Live is on every night.
Why should I know
it's
that?
On the network that you do like three shows on. You should know the lineup.
I'll never know when Free Talk Live is on again because I'm not going to watch it. I'm going to protest and boycott it because they fucking...
Now that you've found the Liberty Radio Network
LRN.FM,
you may want to help expose others to our great programs. To assist you in doing so, you'll find resources at promote.lrn.fm, including details on how to get a free bumper sticker, quarter-page flyers you can print out and distribute, banners for your website, as well as files that will allow you to make your own custom banners and graphics.
Visit it's
promote.lrn.fm.
The Halloween...
Yeah.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living.
God, Dolly Parker needs to move.
And surviving alone. Moving and non swarm his home. Now he must apply Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for survivors on Facebook.
I need a new XLR cable, babe.
Or read chapter one.
Like, this is getting really too sensitive.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
And here we are of studios, lrn.fm. We're also on Ipm Nation, which is another online. And you guys can go check it. And if you are listening to either one of those, feel free to jump at rebelloveshow.com, click on live. You can watch us and interact with us in the chat. If you watch us during the break, sometimes here comes up with some fascinating rants. I get caught on camera. But anywho, I had an interesting article earlier today about FBI warns of an anarchist plot to ambush cops on Halloween. Apparently, they've moved on from ISIS.
Conspiracy theory, like, alert going off. I wish I had that can fly. Because conspiracy theory alert going
now,
off. So, is right directly after the issue, the statement we talked about on our last show, saying that every anti-government group should be considered a terrorist now.
Well, yeah, they've said that before, but they're like they literally made a whole new council about it and whatnot. So I don't want to sound like Alex Jones, you know,
but it's
and come
not.
Across as like a conspiracy nut and a chemtard.
Okay,
but
Okay, so the FBI releases an alert Monday warning NYPD, of course, and police departments nationwide of a potentially dangerous anarchist group that says it plans to ambush cops on Halloween, the extremist group known as the National Libertarian Militia. List freeze.
Liberation. Militia. Now, okay, easy thing to do, Google it.
Google it.
National Liberation Militia.
There should be some link to this giant network of extremists who are planning this master attack of the NYPD.
even if it wasn't like a planned attack, you know, public, but like some sort of Facebook group, a page, a website, you know, an IRC chat, something like a photo on Instagram. I don't know. Any, like, anything to, like, prove that the
can
existence.
I get a Snapchat?
Yeah, is there a Snapchat of it? Like one tiny little thing at all. And I could
nothing.
Not find. I spent like an hour just going through like page after page
we
after
page. We
went
to page 10, like literally. And it, the only thing we could find about. Is close to something that happened in like Colombia in 1942?
No, that's actually like the name of like the militias from Colombia that were during the whole like drug trade and stuff like that. That's a whole different thing, though.
It's a whole different thing, but I just found it really like I should be able to find something other than that is my point.
Every result was literally just another website picking up what the FBI said.
Yeah.
And that's all it is.
No, that's there, it.
It's as if they literally just created it out of thin air. That there's a national liberation militia that are a bunch of anarchists that have proposed a Halloween revolt that encourages supporters to cause a disturbance to attract police and then viciously attack them.
That's what the FBI said. So they issued this statement a couple weeks ago. All these anti-groups need to be stopped. These anarchist people are against the state. Like, they all need to be stopped. And then now, the FBI says that there's this extremist group that we've never heard about anywhere. There's not a link to them. There's absolutely nothing. But the FBI said it. They have proposed a revolt. They're just going to go, and it's going to be a fucking purge of the NYPD. Now, I'm not a conspiracy nut. I don't think so. But, I mean, some things are just plain obvious. Like, that's in broad daylight. Like, it's obviously a setup. It's some kind of, like, facade. That's what I feel like, honestly. Like, they can't issue this statement and then say, oh, now we found this extremist group we were talking about in that other post, and they need to be stopped. So is this, like, some excuse for them to have fucking cops and barricades and barricades while your children are trick-or-treating? Like, we're here to protect you.
Yeah, they're going to be out there and, you know, showing people that they can do cosplay 24/7 because they're wearing their costumes out there to protect all the other people wearing costumes. They just like doing cosplay. Their entire life is cosplay.
Exactly. The cops want to trick or treat and they don't know how to say that. So they need... So they're going to literally be out there guns blazing, you know, to protect you against this like anti-military group. And the main question I get is, What if this happens? Then it proves my point. This is a fucking setup. This is a setup. The government trying to let the people know, like, oh, we're not playing. These anti-government groups need to be stopped. They're all dangerous.
You know, I love how they, like, lump together, like, anti-government groups as
Nazis
usually,
and racists.
Yeah. You know, most anti-government groups I know of are people that practice the non-aggression principle, which is literally, like, the most peaceful peaceniks you can think of, you know. It's fascinating how like that those people are also lambasted with people that are racist and supremacists and or religious fanatics. You know, we're somehow in that process with them.
Somehow. I don't know. I'm pretty racist. But anyway.
You are racist. Oh, my God. You say racist shit all the time.
Well, I can. I play the black card.
That's,
anyway.
That's so fucking racist. Maybe I'll start playing the black card.
You can play the Persian card. So this is the best part of this FBI statement. This group has recommended that members wear typical Halloween masks. And he used weapons such as bricks, bottles, and firearms. Like, one extreme to another. Like, they should use bricks, bottles, and they'll have guns as well. Because bricks in one hand, guns in the other. Wait, babe, I was reading that. Sorry, he distracted me. According to the release,
producer.
Yeah,
folks.
He is. The NYPD Intelligence Bureau is monitoring the threat. And there is no known link between the threat and the New York City law enforcement specifically. So, first of all, the end of this is saying that we really have no idea that they were threatening the NYPD, but we just think that it could possibly be them and everyone's a suspect because they'll be wearing the usual Halloween mask. So I just feel like whatever's about to happen in New York with the NYPD, like, this is not the time for civil disc.
No, don't try any civil disobedience during Halloween in New York.
If you're in New York City and you're listening to this podcast, which you're probably not, be safe out there.
You know, if you're listening to this podcast anywhere, you're probably on some list. So be prepared for like Bearcats to be at your door any minute. I find it just so crazy that like, am I the only one that just simply tries to Google what this National Liberation Militia is? Like, I really didn't find anything on it. News outlets, like any journalist, like, is there any article out there questioning the legitimacy of this militia? You know, was there any research done onto where they are? What's their background? Like, there's nothing.
It's actually a really weird short post. So it just—it's
almost like a—it's like a not even like a blog post, it's like a Facebook post.
Like literally, it's not even a whole paragraph. Like it may be one paragraph altogether. Like that's weird. And I'm not a conspiracy nut, and I've never watched Alex Jones. But if I was, and I was a conspiracy nut, I'd put the two and two together and say they're planning something, and it's not good.
No, they're. It's just a system of control. They're trying to show why they're relevant in the world, why we need the Federal Bureau of Investigation, why we need the NYPD, because we need them so that they can go after those bad anarchists, those bad anti-government people, those libertarians, those horrible pot users,
gays,
you know, the gays,
the blacks,
the Muslims, you know, whatever, when you know all the ethnicities, all the colors, you know, all the niches. Let's go after each and every one.
Only
of them.
One that matters is blue, obviously.
Oh yeah, because if you know blue lives are the only ones that matter. Like, it doesn't matter if you're either like a vet or a hippie. It doesn't matter. They're gonna go after your guns, your pot, your sexual, you know, like how to being openly sexual about who you are, like anything. You know, everyone, they don't care about that, but they do care if you're a cop. Cops are like the most holiest people that you cannot talk shit about with like the super status. They will go to bat for a cop anytime.
Oh yeah, that's like people. That's how you know someone's a good person or not. If you say something about a cop and then they're like, "How dare you disrespect the police? Oh, get the fuck out of here!"
Yeah. Oh no, absolutely.
Yeah, that ends the conversation.
Even if they're like a status,
no,
if they don't like
cops.
The cops or like, yeah, fuck the police, if they're at least on that level with you, like you can both agree that police brutality sucks. But when you have people literally defending, you know, the police as if like they're saints and they're heroes, they're the heroes of America. Like, no, they're not. They kill like thousands of people a year.
They're just thugs. Like, it's the biggest culty thug gang in history. And I mean, if something does happen, and you know, maybe we'll feel like we predicted the future, but let's just everyone be safe out there. Anyway, it was nice talking with you guys.
We'll be at Keenevention coming up this weekend, so go check us out there, and we'll be back after that with a special recap episode.
Peace. Hey.
Are you